Hey, what's up guys? I'm Tiger with Tiger Cabrilla back with another Dokkan Battle video. And today, I'm here to answer a very, very important question, and that is, how many free-to-play tickets can we all expect to receive, specifically on the global side of the game, once the 300 million download celebration has officially begun? And I say specifically on global, mainly because the number of stones that JP players and global players get is different, and today, we're working with the global stone logs, so maybe in the future, I'll make a separate video for the JP side as well. But before we progress any further in this video, I gotta give a massive shout out to Reddit user FishAmorphous for creating this post and saving me literally hours and hours of research digging through old Reddit posts, old news releases, trying to add up the stone logs and the stone counts and dealing with conflicting numbers, and it just would have been so much more complicated than it had to be, but instead, FishAmorphous went ahead and did all the work for us, putting all the info in one neat post, and I really appreciate that, so thank you so much to FishAmorphous for doing that. And a second quick shout out is in order to my boy Apex from the Discord, who actually turned my attention to this post, so thank you to both FishAmorphous and Apex for helping me out big time. And with that said, there is one other thing we have to address real quick, and I think that FishAmorphous actually articulates it very well in this post, so I'm just gonna read it to you guys. So he says, before I start with the actual post, take into consideration that the final calculation may vary, might be different depending on the player. So it could be different for everybody because this only takes into account all the events and campaigns that have released since the 250 million download celebration, which is last August. So those of you with a fresh account could have even more from quest stages and old events. So even more Dragonstones and therefore even more tickets. Also, the final count implies that you have completed every mission, even dailies, and logged in every single day doing all the new released events. Yes, including the punching machine stages and their missions. So basically, he's trying to say the short version is that the final number could be different for everyone depending on what you did during the last year. And let's say, for example, that you took a week off or took a couple days off from Dokkan and didn't do some logins or didn't do some events, or you missed some missions or something like that, then you're obviously gonna have less stones and therefore less tickets, because the way it works is that we're getting one ticket for every 50 stones that we spent since the last download celebration, which was the 250 million download celebration in last August. And if there's something that happened that caused you to get less stones or maybe even more stones, then your final number is gonna be different. And all we're taking into account in this video are the free-to-play stones and therefore the free-to-play tickets that come with that. So if you're one of those people that are like me who spend extra money to buy extra stones in this game, then obviously you're going to be getting more tickets for the amount of stones that you spent, right? So with that out of the way now, we can finally get to the stone count and the ticket count. And we're starting here today with the August 2018 stone log. And as you can see, it says we got 329 stones last August. Now, there's a breakdown here in this specific link, this specific post, but I'm not gonna go into it because that would just take way too much time, like breaking down every single source of stones for each month. So I'll put a link to this Reddit post in my description, and if you guys are curious, you can check it out for yourself, but I'm just gonna like quickly gloss over it and just give you guys the final count for each month. All right, so for August, we got 329, but he says here that we're only taking into account about 80 to 90 of them because we can't count anything before August 27th, because that would have still been the 250 million download celebration stuff. So if we only count everything after the 27th, it's about 80 to 90 stones from last August. And then for September, we got a whopping 558 stones. And I don't remember exactly what the big event was at that time, because it wasn't the anniversary. Maybe there was a big drop or a major dual Dokkan Fest of some kind. I don't remember exactly what it was, but apparently September was a big month. And like I said, if you're curious, you can go check it out. But yeah, apparently September was a major month and we got 558 stones for that. And then for October, we got 177 stones, so a bit of a slow month. November, we got 382 stones. For December, we got 368 stones. I think on average these days, we're getting somewhere between like 250 to 300 stones per month on average. And I've been saying this for a while now. I feel like Dokkan has become more free-to-play friendly in the last year, and these numbers definitely back that up, because before, like maybe 2 years ago, the average number of stones we got per month was somewhere between like maybe 150 to 200, and now it's almost 100 to 150 more than that. And as you can see, yeah, November 382, December 368, even January, which was a bit of a slow month, 254, and February was 567. And this was because it was, yeah, as I thought. So it was the Broly, the Dragon Ball Super Broly and Gogeta Dual Dokkan Fest, and we got a lot of free stuff for that. As you can see, he actually did a breakdown here. I think he might have actually done this by himself, maybe. Maybe not, I'm not really sure, but here's a breakdown to give you guys a quick look. So we got 150 from top grossing, 60 from login bonuses, 67 from missions, 50 from the Facebook campaigns, 68 from new Easy A's, 146 from all these new events, including the Punching Machine, as well as Goku and Arale, Dokkan Battlefield, so on and so forth, and also 17 from helping out JP for their like this Universal Spirit Bomb event that we got recently. So a total of 567 in February, and a big part of that was the Broly and Gogeta Dual Dokkan Fest. And then for March, it was a bit slower, 263 stones. Here's the breakdown again, top grossing, spring missions, all that good stuff, world tournament. And then for April, a bit slower, 216. And here's the breakdown, you guys can see for yourself. Like I said, May was 310, so a pretty standard month right there. And then for June, we only got 146. But if you guys remember, June was one of the slowest months in like global history that I can remember personally. I've been playing this game for 2.5 years now, and there was like just nothing to do in June because it was the month leading up to the 4-year anniversary, and I guess they were just waiting to release all the good stuff for July, right? So man, that was a very tough time as a content creator who focuses on the global side of Dokkan. Yeah, that was rough. But anyways, as you can see, we only got 146 stones, which is kind of indicative of just how boring and how bare the game was. And then for July, look at this. In July, we got a grand total of 853 stones. And of course, the reason for that was because July was the 4-year anniversary month. And for login bonuses alone, we got 163 stones. For missions, we got 138 stones. For world tournament, we got 40 stones. Facebook campaign, we got 32 stones. Easy A's, we got 77 stones. From new events, we got a ton of new events, 203 stones, 160 from top grossing 3 times, and also some miscellaneous stuff like the Spirit Bomb Challenge, as well as the Grand Tour Rewards, for a grand total of 853 stones. Absolutely amazing. And then for August, which is the month we're in right now, it's still incomplete because the month is not over, right? But based on what we know right now, we have 48 for logins, 32 for missions, and we still don't know what the login bonus is going to be for the Super Dragon Ball Heroes World Mission campaign, as well as the daily missions for that campaign, the regular missions, and any other events that we get for that as well. So right now we have 80 for August based on what we know, but it's definitely going to be more than that. And then once we add all of these months up between last August and this August, we're looking at a grand total of 4,254 free-to-play stones. And if you do the math, like I said, one ticket for every 50 stones, right? That is 300 million download celebration tickets for everybody, regardless if you're free-to-play or pay-to-play. Now, obviously, going back to what I said before, this should definitely be taken as more of a rough estimate as opposed to a concrete number. And it's gonna be different for everyone. But if you're one of those people that did everything you possibly could to get every single free-to-play stone between last August and now, then you should definitely be expecting somewhere around this number of free-to-play tickets once the $300 million celebration officially begins. And that is definitely a very solid number of summons for everyone. And considering how good this download celebration banner should be, I sincerely hope that all of you pull at least one unit that you really want from this banner with those tickets. And of course, for people like me who spend extra money to buy more stones, we should also be getting a lot more tickets, which I'm very, very excited for. But at the same time, if you think about it, these celebrations are also painful reminders of just how much money you wasted on this mobile game chasing those rare JPEGs. But you know what? That's not your problem. That's totally my problem. I'll deal with it on my own time. And that's pretty much gonna do it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it and found it informative in some way. And of course, I hope you guys are excited for the 300 million download celebration. It's gonna be a really, really good one. I can feel it. And I hope you guys all pull fire in your summons as well, regardless of how many tickets you end up getting. And yeah, that's pretty much it. As always, if you guys liked the video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button. Join the Tiger Squad now, and while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's all I gotta say, guys. I'm out of here. Hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.